This November, we might be in for a treat from the Leonids, possibly the most significant annual meteor shower in human history. The shower typically peaks every year in the middle of November. But the 2022 production might enthrall viewers and significant sites across the world with a number of encore performances, one of which might be a dazzler. Additionally, this year offers viewers excellent opportunities to record the most of any activity because the declining moon sets before the finest viewing opportunities start. Meteor showers are an unusual occurrence. The amount of meteors one will see with unaided eyes at any particular location is less definite, even though scientists are getting better at predicting when maximum shower activity will occur. When Earth passes through a trail of debris left by the recurring comet 55P Temple Tuttle, the Leonid meteor shower occurs. This comet travels around the Sun once every 33 years, passing through Earth's orbit. Leonid activity typically begins around November 14th, peaks around November 17th, and finishes around November 21st. Just over 2.2 miles broad, the nucleus of 55P Temple Tuttle is a small object. Comparatively speaking, the Leonid meteors are tiny, with most of the dusty bits it scatters in its orbit being no larger than granules of instant coffee. The air around the moving particles becomes heated as a result of friction when these pieces hit our atmosphere, which causes them to glow. As a result, the sky is filled with blazing streaks that are known as falling stars. The Leonid meteors are among the fastest and most powerful. Atmosphere-penetrating fragments travel at a speed of 44 miles per hour. Rapid, needle-like streaks are produced by the tiniest particles. A pea-sized or somewhat larger fragment can produce fireballs that are very spectacular. A Leonid fragment the size of your hand, if you're very lucky, can produce a display as brilliant as the full moon. Even in ideal circumstances, peak Leonid rates can be as low as one meteor every 6 minutes, but more spectacular displays only happen about once every 33 years, occasionally reaching storm levels with at least 1,000 meteors per hour. Although it is not anticipated that the Leonid shower will storm in 2022, some meteorologists believe that it may still dazzle, but not on the night of its customary peak. The classical maximum for this year is predicted by the International Meteor Organization to occur on November 17th at 11 p.m. Universal Time with a zenithal hourly rate of 10 to 15 meteors per hour. This rate represents the greatest number of meteors that, under ideal conditions, perfect darkness, clear skies, and the radiant of the shower overhead, an experienced observer could reasonably expect to see in a single hour. Only a portion of this number is typically visible to most observers. The brightest meteors occasionally leave behind long-lasting light trains, which are cylinder-shaped trails of ionized atoms. Therefore, witnessing a few Leonid meteors can make an observing night unforgettable because they are not only bright, but also quick and colorful. And if Mikhail Maslov of Russia and Makiya Sato of the Nippon Meteor Society are right, we might be in for a surprise after the Leonid's customary peak. Debris is shed by 55P Temple Tuttle as it orbits the Sun, and the solar wind and gravitational interactions can shape this debris into dense streams of material. These streams orbit the Sun in front of or behind the comet, depending on where they are located along the comet's orbit. Whatever dust streams are extant at that time will be encountered by Earth as it crosses 55P Temple orbit. On November 19th, a powerful outburst of Leonid meteors is likely due to a debris stream left by the comet in 1733. Maslov foresees the occurrence at 6 a.m. Universal Time, and Sato foresees it between 6:20 and 6:27 a.m. At least 50 meteors per hour are predicted by Sato. Maslov goes one step further, predicting that the outburst may yield 250 meteors or more, many of which will be significantly brighter than usual. Both options have intriguing potential. The east coast of North America, Western Europe, and Africa will benefit from the eruption if it happens. the duration of the action may be brief. However, if it continues for a while, spectators further west might also be fortunate, particularly from meteors that reach Earth's atmosphere tangentially while the radiant is just beginning to rise. Viewers near North America's east coast and perhaps those in the central time zone may benefit from some extraordinary views. These meteors might last for a long time. A probable activity peak might take place November 21st at 3 p.m. Universal Time as Earth encounters an 1800 debris stream, and a lesser supernumerary peak could come November 18th at 7 a.m. as Earth encounters a debris trail left by a passage around the year 1600. Where do you need to look? Even though shower meteors may be tracked back to a spot in the sickle of Leo, the majority of them appear as light streaks far from that radiant. Shower meteors might seem as a brief, quick flash or as a point source that swells when they are close to or at the radiant. Longer streaks of light will represent meteors that are farther away from the radiant. You should alternate between gazing at the radiant and slightly away, since both are amazing. Ultimately, it's important to be ready for whatever the Leonid shower throws our way, even though we don't yet know which of the 2022 Leonid events will be physically stunning. Always be prepared for the unexpected when watching meteors.